What's up, Flashes, and welcome back. I'm Elliot.
And I'm Lachlan.
Your Frankincense News for October 23rd starts now.
Are you passionate about technology? Ready to turn your love for IT into a rewarding career? Well, join us for a career chat on becoming an information technology expert. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting, our career chat will provide valuable tips, mentorship, and a roadmap for success in the dynamic field of information technology. Don't miss this opportunity to shape your IT future. Sign up for October 24th at 12:30 p.m., either using the QR code posted below or on the counseling website. Your journey to becoming an IT expert starts here.
This year's Red Ribbon Week theme is Be Kind to Your Mind. Live drug-free. The theme is a call to action to speak out in support of healthy choices. It also serves as a reminder that we are all empowered to shape the communities around us through positivity, bravery, and strength, sponsored by the FC SAD Club.
There will be a girls' tennis call-out meeting on Wednesday, November 1st, from 3 o'clock to 3:20 in Coach Keller's room, 425.
Attention Flashes, Franklin Central Theater is proud to present This Random World, a play by Steven Dietz. Shows are November 3rd, 4th, and 5th at 7 p.m. with a 2 p.m. show on the 5th as well. You don't want to miss the show. Scan the QR code or follow the link to purchase your tickets today. See you there.
Please join us at an FC Baseball Spirit Night at Shaker's Restaurant on October 30th from 4 to 9 p.m. No flyer is needed. When paying your bill, just mention it is for FC Baseball and the program receives 20%. It is good dine-in or carry-out.
Are you a fan of scary stories? Want to continue the Halloween vibe after Halloween? Would you like to know what it takes to become an award-winning author? If you answered yes to any of these questions, please come to the Dive Book Club next meeting on November 3rd, 2023, as we discuss The Grey Mist Fair by Francesca Zappia, a FC alumni. We will be meeting in the library with snacks during CCR time. Francesca will also be there to answer any questions about what it takes to become an author and sign copies. If you have any questions, see Ms. Schaefer in room 427. We hope to see you there.
Congratulations to senior Monito Power on achieving the degree of distinction in this National Speech and Debate Association Honor Society after his first place award in original oratory last Thursday's national scrimmage. Other team members who achieved this degree are juniors Megan Gorell and Brooke Camo.
Senior Remedy Little and sophomore Emma Garris have also achieved the degree of merit in the National Speech and Debate Association Honor Society.
Stay up to date with all things FC and Franklin Township at fchsnews.com. Check out the different stories, videos, and more.
Now, will everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'm Bruce Bass, and I play left wing. So I'm planning on playing D1 soccer at Murray State for Matt Lodge. I started playing soccer at 4. My dad played soccer. My mom played softball growing up, and so I was kind of back and forth. Soccer during the fall, softball during the spring, and it got to a point to where I started getting better, and my dad like realized that he wanted to put me in something to where I could improve and get better. So that's when I started doing travel soccer for FC Pride. Lars had asked me that this guy wanted to interview me for what I have been through and was going to ask me questions about how I persevered through what happened. And I think he thought my story was kind of cool and wanted to share that and see like my future plans and whatnot. My dad was definitely a big fan. And I would always hear him yelling in the crowd and whatnot. And I guess not hearing that anymore kind of pushes me to do better because I know he I know he's there still, and I know that he'd want that from me. I feel like I can't stop I can't stop working hard through high school soccer, because I got to be able to work hard through like travel soccer too, and I can't just stop. My dad definitely pushed me to strive for the best, and that was definitely a factor in committing to where I committed. He wanted the best for me, and there were times where I doubted my abilities. Getting the offer from Murray State and talking to Matt about it, I knew it was the right place, and I knew that that's what my dad would have wanted. So high school soccer, it's a great opportunity to make new friends and kind of a new family. And high school soccer is definitely like, I consider my off season, because I'm not doing as much and I'm able to have more fun and kind of relax more. Travel soccer is year round except for during high school soccer season. So right after high school soccer season, I moved straight into travel soccer. Definitely going to miss the team camaraderie. And I guess when I go into college and play at Murray State, I'm gonna be new and people aren't gonna know me. And I guess that I built such a good relationship with my teammates, and I almost feel I'm gonna have to restart. This is my first year being captain. It's definitely a lot of responsibility, but I mean, I've taken it as a learning experience, because I think that this role is gonna help better prepare me for college, and better understanding how to work with my teammates and stuff on and off the field. Well, I've been told that a lot of my teammates look up to me, and that means a lot to me. And that being said and being captain, it kind of helps me keep that work rate up and to continue to push through even rough games that we are struggling to win. It's important to definitely keep working hard and have fun, and really just enjoy the fruits of your labor. All the hard work that you have been through and the times that have gotten really hard, it's definitely worth pursuing more and overcoming all of that, and that it wasn't for nothing.
What did you do over fall break?
Chilled.
Chilled? You know what, that sounds pretty cool. Was that the highlight of your break?
Probably.
I went to Texas.
You went to Texas? Would you say that was the highlight of your break?
Yeah.
Slept.
You slept?
Mm-hmm.
Would you say that's the highlight of your break?
Yeah, for sure. Right. I went to California.
California? Would you say that is the highlight of your break?
Yeah, probably.
Probably? What was the coolest thing you did there?
Probably just like walk around the city and explore stuff.
Nah, I really just worked. I worked at Foot Locker.
Foot Locker?
Yeah.
You were making that money?
Yeah. Substitutes.
Would you say that was the highlight of your break?
Nah. I went downtown, ate at Ruth Chris.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was good.
Just stayed at home.
Just stayed at home?
Yeah.
That's fair. Was that the highlight of your break?
Yeah, pretty much. Being lazy, it was great.
That's awesome. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate that?
Probably a 9.5.
All right. Would you recommend it to others?
Yes, 100%. 100%.
I went to Florida, and I also ate food.
What would you say the best thing you did there?
I would probably say hang out at the beach.
Hang out at the beach? Would you say that's the highlight of your break?
That is definitely the highlight of my break.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate that?
I would rate it an 11 out of 10.
11 out of 10? That's pretty high. All right. Thank you.
What did I do over fall break? I took an SAT.
SAT?
Yes.
How would you rate that on a scale of 1 to 10?
A 3, because SAT.
What did you do over fall break?
Absolutely nothing.
Nothing?
Hell yeah.
Would you recommend that to others?
Yeah. Sleep, eat, and repeat.
Heck yeah, man. All right. Thank you.
All right.
That's all we have for today.
Tune in tomorrow for more FCTV news. And
thanks for watching.